Hello. Yes, good evening. The previous class we have discussed about escape speed or escape velocity. So there is a minimum velocity required by the satellite in order to escape from the gravitational pull. So whenever the gravitational force, due to the gravitational force only, the satellite or any planet revolves around the bigger orbit. How? Because of the centripetal force. This centripetal force and a necessary gravitational force actually provides, due to that the body revolves around the orbit of the earth. When it revolves around the orbit of the earth with a constant velocity, that velocity is called VO, that is called orbital velocity. The gravitational force provides the necessary centripetal force. So, in this, that is a definition, gravitational force. Consider a satellite of mass in moving around a planet of mass capital M in a circular orbit of radius r. Let V bo orbital velocity. This orbital velocity, the gravitational force provides the necessary centripetal force. So, from it is clear that we are going to equate the centripetal force and the gravitational force. So, how we can arrive the result? So, I already told you that what is the centripetal force? Mv squared by r. Instead of v, we have to put v naught. It's equal to, we know gravitational force, g capital M small m by r squared, where capital M, the bigger body mass, small m, smaller body mass. If you are discuss about earth and sun means, capital M denote for sun, small m for earth. If you are man-made satellite, we are sending a satellite from earth surface means earth mass is capital M, you are sending a satellite, the satellite mass is small m. Are you clear? The capital M be bigger mass, small m smaller mass. So from which I can cancel this mm getting cancels, V naught is equal to root of gm by r, rr getting cancels. So what is the formula for orbital velocity? Square root of gm by r. So, I already told you that in the previous class itself, what is the value of small r? Small r always equal to capital R plus h. That is an important thing. The small r is the total distance or radius of the earth. What is called h? How much height above the surface of the earth? Because we are all in surface of the earth. Therefore, the value of orbital velocity is equal to square root of gm by, if you are put capital R, R, gm by R plus H or small r, whatever may be the case. If it is in small r, the small r means R plus H. What is called capital R? Radius of the planet or radius of the earth. Simply substitute it, we can get the value of VO. But in the previous class, we know VO is equal to root of R plus H. VO is equal to root of gr squared by R. Why? Because in the first class derivation itself, gm is equal to gr squared. Therefore, v is equal to, instead of gm, gr squared, we can put gr squared by r. This rr getting cancels. Therefore, vo is equal to root of gr. So, I got orbital velocity root of 2gr. In the previous class, we have discussed that what is the value of escape velocity? Root of 2gr. This is called vo. What is VE? Root of 2gr. Or this can be written as root 2 into gr. So I take 2 out, root 2 into root of gr. Just derived root of gr is called VO. Therefore, VE is equal to root 2 times VO. This is an important thing. That is not in our book, but it is important for solving problem. What is VE? Escape velocity is equal to root 2 times orbital velocity. That means, if we are knowing VO, if we are knowing VO multiplied by root 2, that will give VE. If I want VE, from which V naught can be calculated, VE by root 2, that will give VO. That is a thing you have to understand it. Very important relation. So, first you have to clear yourself by orbital velocity or orbital speed, escape velocity or escape speed. Escape speed, the energy should be concentrated. for orbital speed, the two forces, centripetal force and another force, gravitational force of attraction, we have to equate it. So, both are thing very important, VO and VE. So, there is another heading, what is time period of revolution or time period of satellite, otherwise it is also called as time period of satellite. Time period of revolution. If a satellite actually revolves around the planet means, what is the time taken to complete one rotation or one circular motion is called time period. We already discussed that angular velocity or angular frequency omega is equal to 2 pi by t. We know omega is equal to 2 pi by t. From which t is equal to 2 pi by omega. So, here also the relation between the linear velocity and angular velocity v is equal to r omega. Therefore, here the velocity is nothing but orbital velocity because we are going to study about the period of revolution. Therefore, we should take only orbital speed, not escape speed. But therefore, this omega is nothing but V naught divided by R. So, this omega can be replaced by V naught by R. V naught R goes to the numerator. Therefore, the time period T is equal to 2 pi R. What is VO? Just now we have seen root of GM by R. Since in the denominator, that become root of R by GM. Or simply, I explained here, T is equal to 2 pi 1 by root of GM. This R goes inside. That is r squared. R, if r comes out, r power 1 by 2, r power 1 by 2 into r power 1, that is r power 3 by 2, 1 by root gm. Therefore, t is equal to 2 pi r whole power 3 by 2 by root of gm. Squaring both sides, t squared is equal to 2 become 4, pi become pi squared, r power 3 by 2 whole squared, 2 getting cancels, that become r cube. Root of gm square, simply gm. Then what is the formula for time period? T is equal to 2 pi root of or 2 pi r power 3 by 2 divided by root of gm r t squared is equal to squaring both side, left hand side and right hand side, 4 pi squared by gm into r cube. So what do you infer from that? This t squared 4 constant, pi also constant, g gravitational constant, value 6.63. gm, mass of a particular planet or satellite will be the same. Therefore, radius alone be changed. Therefore, the square of the period of revolution directly proportional to cube of the distance. So, this is nothing but a Kepler's law. Kepler's law also holds good here. Kepler's third law. So, at the end I will tell what is Kepler's third law. The square of the period of revolution directly proportional to cube of the distance r. If T1 and T2 periods of two satellites, this is a single satellite formula. If I take two satellites, they are moving with different periods T1 and T2. Since there are two satellites means radius also differs. If R1 and R2 are the radius of the two satellites, T1 and T2 period of the two satellites means since both are directly proportional, T1 by T2 is equal to R1 by R2. That means T1 squared by T2 squared is equal to R1 cube by R2 cube. This is also important formula for future. So, that gives the period of the satellite or revolution. Next, what is energy of satellite? Energy. Energy is very important. Generally, the energy, total energy is called potential energy plus kinetic energy. Our total energy is equal to E kinetic energy plus E potential. I already discussed that. What is a kinetic energy? Half mv squared. Half mv squared. Here v is nothing but orbital velocity because it revolves. So instead of v, I can put v naught. Therefore, half mv naught squared. Potential energy, I already told you that we derived that potential energy always negative minus g mm by r. If I put only 1 m, gm by r, that is called potential. Gmm by r energy. There is a difference between the potential and potential energy. The potential energy minus Gm by R. So on simplification of M, what about V naught? Root of Gm by R, therefore Gm by R minus Gm. Here, G capital M small m by R. Here, G capital M small by R. This is half value. So here, higher value minus smaller value. Therefore, answer become G capital M small m divided by 2R with a higher value sign minus. Very simple. This one time that value, this is half. 1 minus half, half. Half is the answer. I have put the symbol for higher value minus GMM. Otherwise, you can take like that. That is better. Minus half GMM by R. This is the formula. Minus half GMM by R. So, what do you inform then? From which it is clear that the total energy value and the kinetic energy value have equal. So, here also the answer of GMM by R. The total energy also GMM by half that value. Both are equal in magnitude. But what about direction? The kinetic energy positive, the total energy become negative. Whereas the magnitude of potential energy twice that of the total energy. So if it is multiplied by 2 getting cancelled, this answer comes. Therefore, you have to understand about the energy, the kinetic energy. What is the formula for kinetic energy? Half m v square. Here put instead of v, vo. Is it not? Vo value root of gm by r. So everything we can resubstitute. What do you infer from this? It is clear that the kinetic energy and the total energy both are same with the direction alone differ, whereas potential energy is more, twice that of the total energy. What is called geostationary satellite? So this is an important concept. So most of the, what is called satellite? First we have to understand. What is called planet? What is the difference between the planet and the satellite? Come on, any idea? What is a planet? Any object revolving around the sun is called planet. So, sun at the center, all the well-known planet 9 are revolving around the sun. What is satellite? The generally, the definition of satellite is any smaller object moving around a bigger one is called satellite. Very good natural satellite of Earth is Moon. Moon. Moon is not a planet. Be careful. Moon is not a planet. Moon is a satellite. So whichever revolving around the sun is called planet. What about Moon? Moon revolves around our Earth. So Moon is a smaller object, Earth is a bigger one. The smaller one, Moon, is called satellite. This satellite, we are not sending the Moon, but it's of nature. So that satellite is called natural satellite, Moon. Natural satellite of Earth. So even you go to Saturn, there are 9 moons are there, imaginary. If you are in Saturn, you are seeing the up or high, there are 9 moons visible. That is, even Jupiter, there are 12 moons. Imagine, in the Earth we are having only one moon. So we are enjoying so many quiet using moon for their imagination. If they are in Jupiter or if they are in satellite, imagine how many imagination of thinking coming from the poet. The poet always succeed by using this nature. So naturally satellite is called Moon. The thing of beauty is joy forever. Who told? This was given by John Kitt. We know John Kitt. Very beautiful poet. But he died at the age of 17 or 18. Very young age. But he has written so many about the nature. So why I am telling that the Moon, even our Tamil poet also using Moon for so many imaginations. So, moon is a natural satellite of Earth. Apart from that, we can make satellite by ourselves. Aryabhatta, insert 1A, B, C, apple. Apple was invented by one satellite. What is called apple? So, we know apple. So, only eatable, sir. A for apple. That apple is not that. Apple, A-P-P-L-E. A for Arona, P for passenger, payload experiment. A-P-P-L-E. That apple means Arona, passenger, payload experiment. That also Viking. Everything was sent to the atmosphere from man-made. So, those satellites are called man-made satellite. That is also possible. So, a Earth satellite, so positioned, it appears stationary to an observer on Earth is called geostationary satellite. What is the meaning of that? So, this is the Earth. If I launch a satellite here, so this is Earth, this is a satellite here. Any observer from the Earth, so you are viewing the satellite from the Earth, we feel that the satellite at rest. What is the reason? So, that is the thing you have to understand it. So, we are sitting in our chair, your friend is also nearby you. When you see him, he also in the same position. But we are telling that Earth is on rotation. We won't feel any rotation of the Earth. Why? Because if we are moving, a person are in front of you, others are also moving along with you. So, the relative motion becomes zero. Therefore, it appears at the same position. Like that, the Earth also rotates, the geostationary set also rotates in the opposite direction. So, if it completes in one day, that is also one day in the opposite direction. So, the Earth position comes here, the satellite position also moves. Therefore, when you see that this is the surface seen by the object from the Earth, the same side we are seeing by Earth. But itself rotates. That is the thing. We are also rotating, that is also rotate. Therefore, that appears to stationary. Earth satellite, so positioned, like that we have to keep it on a particular orbit. That is called positioned. It appears stationary. So, it looks stationary from the Earth atmosphere. If we go away from the Earth, we can feel the rotation of that satellite. Also, we can feel the rotation of Earth. Geostationary satellite, its time period of revolution is one day, just now a day. So, Earth rotated itself by one day, morning and evening. So, it revolves round the sun by 1 year. That is, we know the period of revolution of Earth around the sun, it takes 365 days, whereas it rotates itself by one day. It serves as a fixed relay station for long distance television transmission. This geostationary satellite tells so many information for us. So, that is called relay station. So, that observe the picture and then transmit to the Earth. So, everything. So, we are using our cell phone nowadays. Are you everyone with a cell phone in our packet? Am I correct? Yeah. So, we are immediately contact any friend in America or Japan. Immediately you can on it, we can directly speak with your friends. How it is possible? It can be linked with this type of satellite. So, they are sending the signal through microwaves. Microwaves. And actually, Earth receives the microwaves by the cell phone towers and transmit the frequency in terms of radio waves. So, the Earth, we are transmitting the signal for cell phones through radio waves. So, that it is danger. So, that we are, not even though it is not proved properly, but we know because radio waves are high frequency wave. What is the frequency of radio wave? Nearly 100 kilohertz. 200 megahertz. That is the frequency of radio wave. 1 kilo means 10 cube, mega means 10 power 6, such a very high frequency. If high frequency wave continuously receives by us means that causes some damage. So that we cannot use or we should not use cell phone frequently. Avoid cell phone, that is better. That is advice of all the scientists because it is operated by high frequency. If R is the radius of geostationary orbit, so this orbit actually, this is an orbit. If it is a radius means the distance of the geostationary satellite and the center of our Earth. If R is the orbit, M is the mass of the Earth, T is the time period, then just now we have seen what is called period of revolution, T square is equal to 4 2 squared by Gm by R cube. Just now we have derived. Or keeping R cube there, so you should not confuse with this R and this R. This R is called arbitrary of satellite. Capital R is called radius of the Earth. Capital R always equal to small r is equal to capital R plus H. Be careful. That is, so from this, Gm by R squared into R squared T squared by 4 pi squared. That is Gm by R. R is called radius of the Earth, not radiating. It is called radius, R-A-D-I-U-S, radius of Earth, radius of the Earth. We know Gm is equal to Gr squared, so that I put R cube, keeping R cube here, all others are goes there in that T. Therefore, G is equal to Gm by R squared. Therefore, I want to find out the value of R means cube to root of this value, that is whole power 1 by 3. So, kindly make note of this. Geostationary satellite. We know T square is equal to 4 T square by Gm by R cube. So, keeping R cube here, if Gm by 4 T square go on the other side, that becomes the answer, become the value. Changes. T is equal to, this is a thing. T square is equal to 4 T square. This is 4 pi square. Kindly correct this derivation. Then only confusion comes. T square is equal to 4 pi squared by Gm into R cube. Therefore, R cube, keeping R cube here, Gm goes under the Gm T squared by 4 pi squared. Okay. That is the thing I want to understand it. So here what happened? Why this answer comes? So kindly make note of this, you should not confuse that. So in this equation, multiply and divide by R squared. So, for convenient, for this R cube is equal to Gm T squared by 4 pi squared. In this equation, I multiply by R squared and also divide by R squared. R squared by R squared. So, that value may not be changed. Therefore, R cube is equal to, we know Gm is equal to Gr squared T squared by 4 pi squared. Because G equal to Gm by R squared. So, in order to make that value, I have to multiply that R squared and R squared comes. That is the thing. G is equal to Gm by R squared. G is equal to Gm by R squared. This Gm by R squared can be replaced by G, remaining R squared T squared by 4 pi squared. So what is unnecessary? I multiply by r square by r square means I have to replace the value of gm by r square in terms of gravitational acceleration due to gravity. So that we know g 9.8, radius of the earth 6.4 into 10 power 6, that means 6400 kilometer into time period of earth 24 hours, 24 per day, that may be converted into second by 3600, that whole square divided by 4 into 3.1 whole square whole power 1 by 3. So, on substituting the current value of R is equal to 42.33 into 10 power 6. Otherwise, why approximately you should know the value? What is called R? R is nothing but R plus H. That is the arbitrary of satellite from the earth surface. So, we have to send the satellite from the earth surface above the earth surface by 42 into 10 power 6 meter above. So, this is actually an orbit radius of your satellite, because the previous thing I have given, let R be the radius of geostationary orbit, so that the value of R become 42.33. So, such a thing we have to send on satellite. So, simple modification of derivation. Then, what are Kepler's law of planetary motion? This is a final solution. Kepler's law. So, usually, what is Kepler's law? If you are already in a final examination, nobody knows about Kepler's law, can be written in a paper, isn't it? So, give me a paper, I will write. What is Kepler's law? The law invented by Kepler is known as Kepler's law. Is it correct? So, anyone, simply you can write page and page without knowing Kepler's law. But it is not so far entrance examination is concerned. We have to pinpoint. The first law state, first Kepler's law, first law. So, this is a sun. All the planets revolving round the sun in an elliptical orbit with the sun one of the foci. The first law, kindly write yourself. All the planets revolving round the sun in an elliptical orbit with the sun as a focus or foci. So, we have to see the sun from any position of the orbit. That is called first law. What is second law? The second law is very important. So, suppose it is a sun is here. So, suppose the earth come at one position, second position it come. This is a distance between the sun and the earth. So, suppose that may be come very close to the sun also. What is the area covered? These two areas are equal. That is second law. That means the aerial velocity, sweeps equal areas in equal intervals of time. The aerial velocity sweeps equal area in equal intervals of time. That means if we come to very far away from the sun, if it comes very close to the sun, what is the area? Area will be the common. That is second law. The third law is universal law, you know. Just now I already told you that the period of revolution. So suppose I take a earth. Earth starts from here. It complete one revolution. What is the time taken? The square of period of revolution is always cube of the distance between the sun and the planet. So this is sun. This is earth main. This distance is called R. Therefore, the period of revolution, square of the period of revolution, directly proportional to cube of the distance between sun and the planet. These are the three important laws. So, next as usual, we go for problems, where also we complete the gravitational motion also. So, these are all the fundamental things. Now we are coming to nation. The first problem, so kindly imagine our topic, simply substitute it, we can get the answer. Problem 1, a space probe means satellite, we are sending, is fixed from the earth towards the sun. So, this is earth, this is sun, I place a space probe somewhere in between earth and the sun. How far from the earth will the sun's gravitational pull on the probe balance the earth pull? Are you, what is the problem here? So it is a probe, it is earth, it is sun. The probe may be having gravitational pull of earth as well as a gravitational pull of sun. We know the gravitational pull of sun is more than that of earth pull. So if it is very near to sun, what happen? The probe immediately go and hit the sun, but it balances in at what distance of the probe to balance from the earth pull. So the distance they ask, mass of the sun is given, mass of the earth is also given, between earth and the sun, the distance r is equal to 1.5 and distance. How can you calculate it? So as far as this problem is concerned, this is the diagram, let it be. We know g mass of the sun into mass of the probe divided by the distance squared. Let the distance is x, therefore from the sun r minus x the whole squared. Balances means G capital M mass of the earth into mass of the probe divided by x square. So the question is, this distance they asked, x. So it total distance is r, it revolves around the orbit. Therefore the total distance between the sun and the r minus x, that is it. G m m by r square, there is a gravitational force, this is a gravitational pull of sun, that is a gravitational pull of earth. Therefore r minus x divided by x is equal to root of mass of the sun by mass of the earth. Am I correct? Because g getting cancels, small m getting cancels. R minus x by x square is equal to ms by me. So squaring, I take the square, r minus x by x means root of ms by me, simply. So that is equal to square root of mass of the sun 2 into 10 power 30, that is a given value, divided by mass of the earth 6 into 10 power 24, that is equal to 1 by 3, isn't it? If 24 means 10 power 6, that answer is 10 cube divided by root 3, am I correct? So this is the value of r minus x by x is equal to 10 cube by root 3, or I keep r by x here. Already on the other side, 10 cube by root 3 will be there, x by x become minus 1, if goes other side, plus 1. So that is equal to root 3 is a common LCM, that become 10 cube plus root 3. Very clear now, r by x minus x by x 1, if 1 goes on other side, 10 cube by root 3 plus 1, r by x is equal to 10 cube by root 3 plus 1, r 10 cube plus root 3 by root 3, common LCM, r x nearly is equal to r into root 3 divided by 10 cube. So not approximately, nearly equal, because 10 cube plus 1.732. So I can neglect that root 3. So 10 cube by root 3 is equal to r by x, or x is equal to r into root 3 by 10 cube. You can neglect it because approximation. So in the problem, r value is given as 1.5 into 10 power 11. We know root 3, 1.732 divided by 10 cube. On simplification, 2.6 into 10 power 8 meter. 2.6 into 10 power 8 meter. So this is the answer. So from the earth surface at a distance of 2.6 in 10 power 8 meter, it is balances. Otherwise, if it is more than that, it moves towards the sun. Are you clear? Go to second problem. Calculate the height above the earth surface at which the value of acceleration due to gravity is half its value on the earth surface. So kindly make note of this problem. It's a repeated problem also. Calculate the height above the earth surface at which the value of acceleration due to gravity is half its value of the earth at the surface. Are you clear? So it is a earth thing. So I have an earth like that. This is R. It is a height H. Your acceleration gravity g means here the value is g by 2. That is a given in the problem. Now what is acceleration due to gravity at height? Gh by g. We already given the same step. It's equal to r divided by r plus h the whole square. That is given as half. So the same step we are given, because we know g is equal to gm by r square, already we know gh is equal to the same step I have given in the derivation, gm by r plus h the whole square, am I correct? Therefore gh by g, so gm gm getting cancels, r by r plus h squared, that is equal to half given the problem, r the value of r by r plus h is equal to 1 by root 2, because square I take 1 by root 2, or I want to find out cross multiplying, what happened? R plus H is equal to root 2 R. R H is equal to root 2 R minus R. That is equal to root 2 minus 1 into R. Kindly make note of this step. So, R by R cross multiplying. R plus H is equal to root 2 R, or H is equal to root 2 R minus R. So I take R out. Therefore, root 2 minus 1 into R. So we know root 2 minus 1. What is root 2? 1.414 minus 1. That become 0.414 into radius given 6400. So kindly make those are given, it's not 6500, 6400 kilometer. Kindly alter the problem. Given radius always 6400 kilometer, then multiply by 4.41 by 4, that become 2649.6 kilometer. 2649.6 2649.6 kilometer. That means 0.414 into 6400. So this is the second problem. Take the next one. Third one. This also you have to, manipulations are there. The escape velocity of a body on the surface of the earth is 11.2 km per second. Your body is projected away with twice its speed. What is speed of the body at the infinity? Ignore the presence of other heavenly bodies. Because it attracts, we have to take it into consideration. Kindly avoid. Ignore. So how can you calculate this problem is concerned? So two velocities, v is called velocity of projection, let it be. We have to project the body with the velocity of v. V dash is the velocity at infinity, that is you have to calculate what is the value of v dash. We know energy conservation principle, energy conservation. Already given by the energy conservation principle of m v squared minus potential energy minus r. This is a total energy, kinetic energy plus potential energy. Potential energy is always negative, just now we have seen. That is equal to of m v dash squared plus 0. Why I put 0? At infinity, the potential energy becomes 0. Kinetic energy also 0. Why? Here we have to calculate the value so that I put, otherwise everything is 0. Okay. Of m v squared, everything. So this m getting cancels. Okay. Here v is nothing but 2 times v. Am I correct? Why? Why? Because escape velocity root of gr, that is body goes twice the problem. Kindly go through the problem. A body is projected, velocity about of the surface of the earth is 11.2 km. A body is projected away with twice of the speed. The problem itself given twice of that speed, that means escape speed 2v. That is a problem given. Okay. Therefore, substitute there, half m already cancels, v squared means 4v squared minus gm by r is equal to half v dash squared. Okay. So, that become 2v squared. Simply 2v square. Okay. 2v square. What is m? Second step, of v dash square. Simply a substitute, v is equal to 2v. So v square is equal to 4v e square. 2 getting cancels. We know escape speed v is equal to square root of 2gm by r. Vo gm by r, v is equal to 2gm by r. Substitute here, what happened? 2 v e squared, that become 2 into 2gm by r. minus gm by r is equal to v dash squared by 2. So 2 into 2 to 4, 4 gm by r minus gm by r become 3 gm by r. So be careful, 3 gm by r is equal to v dash squared by 2. Therefore, I want to find out v dash squared is equal to 6 gm by r. These two goes multiply. So, that is equal to, what is v again? Root of 2 gm by r, v squared 2 gm by r 3 times, that is multiply by 3, 3 into 2, 6. Therefore, this is nothing but 3 times v squared. That is a thing I want to find out. V dash squared is equal to 3 times v squared. How it comes? Because v dash squared is equal to 6 gm by r. We know v is equal to 2 gm by r. Squaring, v squared is equal to 2 gm by r. Multiply both sides, 3v is equal to 6 gm by r. Therefore, this 6 gm by r can be written as v squared. So, very simply, I want to find out what is the value of v dash equal to root 3 times v. Root 3 we know 1.732 into v given in the problem 11.2 kilometer. And multiply these two, the answer become 19.4 kilometer per second. The answer is 19.4 kilometer per second. So, very simple problem. So, what is the concept here? The energy conservation principle, from which we can substitute the given value v is equal to 2 v dash. So, otherwise only mathematical manipulation. The final solution, v dash square is equal to 3 v square. V value always given, substitute this you can get. Very interesting problem also. We can go to the another problem. If the mean distance of Jupiter from the sun is 5.3 AU, it is not AV, AU, astronomical unit. How many years Jupiter takes to complete one revolution around the sun? One astronomical unit is nothing but mean distance of Earth from the sun. So, we already discussed that the square of period of revolution, the square of the period of revolution of Jupiter divided by square of period of revolution of sun and the Earth. That is the thing we have to understand it. Distance of the Jupiter from the sun. Square is equal to, I already given r1 by r2 whole cube, r1 cube by r2 cube. Therefore, the period of revolution of Jupiter is equal to, this is Earth. I have given the value of Tj is equal to 5.2, there is not 3, 5.2. The problem is, if the mean distance of Jupiter from the sun is 5.2, therefore 5.2 whole power 3 by 2 into T, time period of Earth. Okay, that is Tg. Tj is equal to Te squared R1 cube by R2. This R1 by R2 given as 5.2. The mean distance of Jupiter from the sun is 5.2 into the TE value. That is the thing we have to understand it. What is the time period of Earth to revolve around the sun? 1 year, we know. 1 year. Therefore, simply Tj is equal to 5.2 whole power 3 by 2 into 1. So, that nothing about 11.2 9 years. What is a Jupiter to complete the sun? For revolution of sun, it will take 11 years. What about the earth? 1 year. So simply this is a time period of satellite. You know, Jupiter squared by earth squared is equal to R1 by R2 whole cube. Therefore, Tj is equal to R1 by R2 whole cube into T squared. R cube through to square root on both sides. Root of R1 by R2 whole power 3 is nothing but R1 by R2 whole power 3 by 2. If the mean distance of Jupiter from the Sun is 5.2 astronomical unit, how many years of Jupiter can be taken into concern? One astronomical unit is nothing but the distance of mean distance. That is called the thing you have to understand it. So, this completes your gravitational motion also. And tomorrow we will start a very important motion called simple harmonic motion. So, after that we can come to for fluid because the motion completes. So, first we have seen linear motion, then two dimensional motion, circular motion, rotational motion, now the gravitational motion. Tomorrow we will see the important topic. Simple harmonic motion, the maximum question comes from this unit for your NEET examination. Thank you.